designers, welcome to the Vindicator. In this video, we'll discuss conformal cooling. This technology is very futuristic and very new to injection molding. I referred a lot of websites, blogs, and selected most important points and bought especially for you as a study material. This video is going to be very interesting. Keep watching till end, like the video, and subscribe the channel. Press the bell icon. We will start with the basic. So why the cooling is important in injection molding? Cooling is nothing but to maintain the mold temperature in a single line, you can say. But in deep, when the polymer is entered into the injection mold, it will get crystallized. When it gets crystallized, its temperature will be formed by the mold steam, or it will get transferred to the mold steam. If you are running your mold in the same scenario, you are feeding the polymer and temperature is transferring to the mold steam and you are not applying any cooling. To some extent, steam will get its heat up. It will get heat up and some extent it will stop accepting the further temperature from the polymer. Then polymer not losing its temperature, then its own characters get affected. It will get affected. Then obviously what mold processor will make, he'll increase the mold cycle time. After observing this condition, we can conclude three things will get affected without cooling. One is mold stain itself, because in the long run mold stain will get creep and its quality will get damaged. And second one is product. If you are not providing a proper cooling, you can't achieve it characteristics or dimension and aesthetics of the part. So cooling is important for part also. And third one is cycle time. If you are not running your mold with the proper cooling, it will affect mold cycle time. If you are running your mold with the high cycle time, it means you are losing your money and it is not economically good. Okay. Before understanding conformal cooling, we should understand our conventional type cooling and its limitation. Here I brought some examples and we will discuss one by one. This is rectangle cooling. To manufacture this, we should drill 5 drills, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and we should plug the opening of the drill. By this, so we will create a closed circuit. This is for simple part. Here we can see same rectangle cooling but in a different level. 1, 2, 3. All these three levels got connected with vertical line, vertical cooling line. This is also produced by drilling. Okay. And this is angular type. If your core is conical and you have to reach a depth of the part, you can select this type of cooling. This can produce with the drilling 4 drills, 2 drills angularly and 2 drills vertically or horizontally. By plugging opening of the drill, you can create the angular type cooling method. And third one is buffer type. If your part is very tiny and height is very more, then you should go for buffer type. Here you can see a big drill has been drilled from the in mid of the part and it got reached by dividing the same cooling line into two. To divide the cooling line, we have used buffer blades, or it's called straight buffer. Here you can see the spiral buffer also can be used. Okay, and this is mild cooling channels. As in this type of cooling most for the flat type part, and you can see the cross section of the channel. It's not round, it's a square. You can mill this channel by milling machine and seal the area with the O-ring, and you can tighten it into the coat plate. Okay. In this chart, you can see there is 60-70% of mold cycle time is covered by cooling.
By this method, by this chart, we can understand cooling is very important and it is consuming most of the Mould cycle. As of now, I hope I made you understand essentiality of the cooling and type of cooling channels and how it to be manufactured. And now it comes time to discuss on challenges we are facing in our current cooling method. In our current cooling method, we try our best to reduce the cycle time to get more productivity. We are using beryllium copper, we are using many more alloys, even though we have not reached that drastic changes in our cycle time. We can see there are many more machines has come to the market which can run in 3 second, 4 second, 5 second interval, but we being a Mould designers, we have not yet reached that kind of manufacturability to reach very less cycle time. And part requirement, some part needs very good aesthetic quality and thickness will be very more in some part. There is some restriction. If thickness is more, certainly we will get some warpages, we will get some missing mark. So there is some part requirement which is due to the which is also due to the cooling. Okay, then limitation due to the part geometry. If some parts are very deep, some parts are very curvy, due to this our cooling channels won't reach those areas. As we doing only milling and drilling for the cooling line, we are not using any new technology on this. So there is also a limitation to reach a difficult part geometry. To fulfill our challenges, here you can see the new technology has came. It's called conformal cooling. In this picture, we can see that it is conventional cooling. We are drilling and connecting our drilling holes to create a circuit. This is our conventional cooling. In this conformal cooling, you can see it's uneven, snaky like cooling can be produced with the help of the conformal cooling. Here there is no need of plugs, there is no need of any type of conventional machining, and there is no limitation. If it is curvy also can be produced, if it is straight also can be produced. So any type of cooling lines according to the part geometry can be produced with the help of conformal cooling method. So let's see what is this conformal cooling method in detail. So this technology, how it's work? It uses additive manufacturing technology. This additive manufacturing technology is a technology which invented by the Chart Hull in 1984. Basically this is a 3D printer. Additive manufacturing, I think it's a 3D printing. In 3D printing, as we know, we only use it for the plastics. In this conformal cooling, we will use metal 3D printed. Hope you got some idea. In 3D printer, there are three types of 3D printer. One is stereolithography, fused deposited method and selective laser sintering. For the conformal cooling, we are using selective laser sintering. It's called SLS. This is stereolithography. You can see this. You can Google this method. Okay, this is deposit method. Here you can see the nozzle will is depositing the material layer by layer, depositing. And third one is selective laser sintering. This is SLS. So with the help of this method only, we are going to create our conformal cooling. Okay, the machine something looks like this. So here you can see how the part going, this type of part going to get cooled. It's having very thin ribs and very uneven geometries. You can't drill or you can't mill anywhere here. To help this type of part, you can see I'm playing a video, a small bit. You can see the cooling channels. So this type of cooling channels can be made with the help of conformal cooling. Okay. So how this type of cooling to be, how this type of cooling can be manufactured? So the question comes now. For that, also play another video next to this. Okay, this is a small bit video. Here a designer checking your insert. It's a core insert. Here you can see the cooling channels already been designed. And designers confirm the all cooling channels and all the model will get converted into the layer method, because this method will work layer by layer. So here he is inspecting the layer and is installing the pre-manufactured insert. On top of this, the cooling going to be produced. We will place this pre-manufactured insert in the machine. This is the machine which I shown you earlier. And the laser will first inspect the positioning of the insert and work will get started. The laser will in a single layer, it will merge the steel powder which is around its machine. Here you can see in the animation the head of the machine will produce the laser layer by layer, and it will create solid, it will solidify the material around the insert and it will create the core insert. This is a core insert which I am showing now. Okay, work is done. And this is all the powder which is of same material. It is of tool steel only. This is a tool steel material. And all the excess material will be removed and your core insert is ready. It's nice, na? We will discuss advantages, disadvantages and limitation of conformal cooling. The first one is, can create cooling channel according to the part geometry. There are wide range of part geometry can be produced with the help of conformal cooling. And there is no change in mold steel. There are many type of tool steel around us, like P20, S13, S11. Whichever tool steel which you preferred, that can be produced with the help of conformal cooling. Reduce cycle time by half. Now, best part is reducing the cycle time only. If you are getting a cooling according to your part geometry surfaces very well, then obviously your cycle time will reduce drastically. This will also help your reducing your cycle time. If your cycle time is getting reduced, then obviously your production rate will get high. It also will get a good aesthetic part quality. And if there is equal efficient cooling is there, obviously your part quality will get high. Okay. There are some disadvantages also. High manufacturing cost. As we seen, there are very modern futuristic machines and equipments are used in this method. So obviously the cost going to be very high, and a small manufacturer, a small industrialist can't afford this type of technology. Hope one day when machines will get manufactured more and that machine cost will get reduced, then maybe one day everyone can be use this method. Required secondary operation. After manufacturing the core in the SLS method, accuracy of your core insert or cavity insert can't be maintained in this method. So there should be secondary operations like 3-axis milling, or after that polishing also necessary. And lead time is more due to less number of manufacturers. Yeah, there are many. I think there are 5 to 6 manufacturers. I think in India, not having much details on it, but manufacturers are very less. Due to this, approach time and lead time, everything is going to be more. And limitation, works mainly on insert. with certain sizes. As you see, the machine is very small and only inserts can be manufactured, and you can't go beyond some certain sizes. If you are making some big size, the size of the machine is not available with me, but certainly this is the, there is a size limitation, and you can't make integral core and cavity type, because big inserts can't be manufactured. Okay, there is another limitation, and there is no much care or designers to create this type of designs. Some CAD manufacturers has already included conformal cooling in their CAD software, but not everyone, and there is no designers much aware on this type of creating this type of designs also. Okay, these are some limitation. I think over the period of some time, this can be eliminated. This limitation can be eliminated, but disadvantage, this can't be avoidable, because this is going to cost more, and this time going to be very more. Okay,
I hope you enjoyed the video and learned something new today. Thank you for watching. I'll keep on posting such good videos. Stay connected, subscribe the channel, and share among your friends. I'll meet in next video. Thank you.